Welcome to loading and scripting content on the DMP-8000 with Show Control System. This video will explain the process of copying content onto the VNet computer, then creating a button in Display Studio to play that content on the display. Follow along on screen or on your own DMP-8000 and Show Control computers as we explore the program. The term content is used to define any visual image that appears on the display. This could be a still image, such as a JPEG picture, or an animated graphic, such as an AVI file. If content has been created using a third-party software, it is often copied to the VNet computer using a flash drive, or downloaded if your system has access to the internet. These files need to be stored in a specific location in order for VNet to read them. To simplify this process, these folders are often mapped as a drive letter that appears under My Computer on the Show Control desktop. If your system's drives are not mapped, they can be found by going to My Computer, Network, select the VNet Primary Computer, Content. Before we begin loading content, let's look at the folder structure of the DMP-8000. The VNet folder is located in the Program Data folder on either the D or the C drive. If the Program Data folder is not there, you need to make it visible by adjusting the settings in the control panel. Once the Program Data folder is visible, follow to Daktronics VNet 4. In the VNet 4 folder, you will see a subfolder titled Content. All content must be placed in the Content folder either directly or in a subfolder if you choose. The Content folder itself must remain unaltered. Back on the Show Control computer, place a piece of content into the content folder by copying it from its source. Now that the content is in the correct folder, it can be played on the system by scripting a button in Display Studio. In the Display Studio software, make sure a scripting container is set up by right-clicking in the gray space and selecting New, Scripting Container. Inside the container, right-click the empty area and select New Button. We will now add the command to the button to play the content to the display in a process called scripting. Click the plus symbol. This will add a new line of script. Notice the 5 steps at the top of the box. These steps will help guide you through the scripting process. In step 1, choose DMP-8000 player control. Then click step 2. In step 2, choose the sign you want to play content to. Click step 3. In step 3, select Play, then move on by clicking on Step 4. Click the Add button to browse to the item to be played. Once a selection is made, click on Step 5. Continuous should already be selected. This will play the file continuously until a different button is clicked. Name the button by highlighting the word Play in the top text field and entering a name to describe that button. Finally, click Save. When the button is clicked, the script will activate and play the content to the display. This concludes loading and scripting content on the DMP-8000 with Show Control. Continue to the next video for more information.